Hello and welcome. You're watching India Ahead with me, Neha Khanna. Our big focus tonight, as concerns grow over the imminent third COVID wave, the overall Omicron tally across India now stands at nearly 600 cases. The national capital, meanwhile, has seen a massive jump in its overall COVID cases in the last 24 hours, recording 331 cases, the highest since the 9th of June. 142 of these are confirmed Omicron cases. A night curfew kicks in here in Delhi starting tonight from 11 p.m. to 5 a.m. Now, more than six states have imposed night curfews in the hope to contain the further spread of COVID. A move that has been questioned by many experts who ask, does coronavirus get transmitted only at night? Many have also raised pertinent questions about how it is all right for governments to impose restrictions on ordinary citizens while politicians go about addressing mega rallies attended by thousands of people, with most, including netas, not even wearing masks. These political rallies are, without a doubt, super spreaders. Recently, the Allahabad High Court urged the Centre and the Election Commission to consider deferring the assembly polls scheduled to be held in five states early next year in view of the surging COVID cases. We all saw what happened when the last set of assembly elections in West Bengal and elsewhere happened earlier this year, right in the middle of the devastating second COVID wave. So we're asking tonight, will our netas ever learn any lessons? Why different rules for them and the common citizens? Do night curfews really help in containing the spread of COVID? And is India prepared for the third COVID wave projected to strike early next year, triggered by the Omicron variant?
दिल्ली में आज रात 11 बजे से नाइट कर्फ्यू लग जाएगा और हर रात 11 बजे से सुबह 5 बजे तक ये नाइट कर्फ्यू जारी रहेगा. जिस तरह से ओमिक्रॉन के केसेस बढ़ रहे हैं उसको देखते हुए दिल्ली सरकार की तरफ से ये फैसला लिया गया है. अब ऐसे में आम जनता इसके बारे में क्या सोचती है, इस पर जवाब जानने के लिए हमारे साथ कुछ लोग मौजूद हैं, इनसे बातचीत करेंगे. ये बताइए, जो ये नाइट कर्फ्यू लगाया जा रहा है, आपको क्या लग रहा है, ओमिक्रॉन क्या सिर्फ रात को ही फैलता है? जिस तरह से ये फैसला लिया गया है, आपके हिसाब से ये फैसला कैसा है, सही है, गलत है या क्या है?
मैम, जो सरकार ने फैसला लिया होगा तो अच्छा ही लिया होगा, कुछ ना कुछ सोच के ही लिया होगा. क्योंकि देखो, का रोज़गार किस तरह से गरीबी फैल रही है, इस टाइम काम लोगों के पास नहीं है कुछ भी.
नाइट कर्फ्यू को लेकर
बेटा ज़्यादा फायदा नहीं होगा, क्योंकि सब लोग अपने घरों में होते हैं ज़्यादातर. नाइट से क्या फ़र्क पड़ेगा, तो गवर्नमेंट पता नहीं कैसे कर रही है, पर नाइट से कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ने वाला. डे में थोड़ा सख्ती होनी चाहिए.
नाइट कर्फ्यू लगाया गया वो फैसला तो अच्छा है, लेकिन अगर देखा जाए तो नाइट में तो लोग घर में ही रहते हैं. अगर ज़्यादा बेटर हो कि दिन में कुछ ऐसा किया जाए, जैसे कि मैम बताई आपको, सैटरडे संडे अगर हमारा लॉकडाउन होता है, जैसे फ्राइडे को जैसे संपूर्ण लॉकडाउन करते हैं, सैटरडे संडे फ्राइडे लॉकडाउन कर देते हैं रात को 9 बजे से, सीधा मंडे को हम सुबह 6 बजे खोलते हैं, तो इससे हमारा क्या होगा, चैन टूटेगा मैम. अगर सैटरडे संडे पूरा संपूर्ण लॉकडाउन होता है तो इससे चैन टूटेगा.
अब ऐसे रोजगार वाले तो रोज़ के कुआ खोदेंगे, वही खाते हैं, अब वो परेशान नहीं हो जाएंगे, आम जनता बहुत परेशान हो जाएगी अगर लॉकडाउन लग जाएगा.
लॉकडाउन नहीं लगाया गया, नाइट कर्फ्यू लगाया गया है.
धीरे धीरे बढ़ा देंगे ना उस चीज़ को, अभी नाइट लगाया और धीरे धीरे बढ़ाते जाएंगे उसे, देगा कर देंगे फिर, इससे तो दिक्कत हो सकती है ना मैम.
बिल्कुल. तो यहाँ पर अभी जहाँ नाइट कर्फ्यू में जनता परेशान है या नहीं, हम ये जानने के लिए पहुँचे, तो वहीं कुछ लोगों के मन में लॉकडाउन को लेकर डर है कि अगर लॉकडाउन लग जाता है, क्योंकि संक्रमण तो तेज़ी से फैल रहा है, तो ऐसे में स्थिति गंभीर हो सकती है. फिलहाल ज़्यादातर लोगों का यही मानना है कि नाइट कर्फ्यू से कुछ खास फर्क पड़ने वाला नहीं है. ऐसे में नाइट कर्फ्यू की बजाय एक दिन का या दो दिन का वीकेंड लॉकडाउन लगना चाहिए. वीडियो जर्नलिस्ट कौशल के साथ पूजा चौरसिया, इंडिया है.
कीपिंग इन माइंड द इंक्रीजिंग केसेस ऑफ ओमिक्रॉन, द गवर्नमेंट हैज इम्पोज्ड नाइट कर्फ्यू फ्रॉम 24th of December, बट एज यू कैन सी इन अ डे टाइम देयर इज अ लॉट ऑफ रश इन द मार्केट. लेट मी ग्रो अक्रॉस द पीपल एंड आस्क देम व्हाट दे थिंक. मैम, गवर्नमेंट ने नाइट कर्फ्यू लगाया हुआ है, बट डे में आप देख रहे हैं कितनी भीड़ हो रखी है, तो उसके लिए क्या करना चाहिए गवर्नमेंट को? क्या दिन में भी कर्फ्यू लगाना चाहिए?
नो, दिन में तो कर्फ्यू नहीं लगाना चाहिए, क्योंकि नॉर्मल जो भाई हमारी जो ज़रूरतें हैं वो कैसे पूरी होंगी. दिन में कर्फ्यू लगाने से तो बहुत दिक्कत हो जाएगी.
पर मैम, केसेस भी तो इतने बढ़ रहे हैं, तो उसके लिए फिर
केसेस बढ़ रहे हैं, लेकिन टाइमिंग होनी चाहिए जैसे पहले था, टाइमिंग के हिसाब से होना चाहिए.
देखिए, डे कर्फ्यू लग के तो पूरा हो नहीं पाएगा, लोग उसको तोड़ेंगे, नियम तोड़ेंगे, लेकिन हाँ, कन्वीनियंस के हिसाब से थोड़ा सा टाइम स्लॉट होना चाहिए, तो कुछ तो बढ़ाने ही पड़ेंगे कदम, नहीं तो पिछली बार वाले हालात फिर होंगे, क्योंकि लोग तो अपने आप को समझते नहीं है. गवर्नमेंट को तो स्टेप उठाने ही पड़ेंगे, लेकिन हाँ थोड़े से ऐसे होंगे कि थोड़ा सा अरेंज ऐसा होना चाहिए चीज़ों को कि लोगों को असुविधा भी ना हो, लेकिन ये क्राउड पे कंट्रोल होना चाहिए। ये
सबसे पहली बात तो प्रोटोकॉल्स को फॉलो नहीं किया जाता है। एक गज की दूरी, दो गज की दूरी की जो बात चलती है वो सबसे पहली बात यहाँ पे आपको कहीं भी नहीं दिखेगा, मास्क के साथ भी। हालांकि ये बात अलग है कि हम जूस पी रहे हैं तो मास्क नहीं पहन रखे हैं। डे कर्फ्यू लगानी चाहिए जब तक केसेस ड्रॉप नहीं होते हैं।
The public is saying that there should be a time slot, there should be a restrictions that some shops should be open at this time and other shops should be open on other time. This is Arzu Seth with cameraman Rohit Mishra, India Ahead, Lucknow.
All right, let's introduce our panel of experts. Joining me on the show tonight, Dr. Sunila Garg, member of the Lancet COVID-19 Commission and advisor to the Indian Council of Medical Research. Dr. Anusha Rohit, a microbiologist, also joining us from Chennai. In a moment, we're also hoping to be joined by Dr. Sameer Gupta, co-chair, healthcare, PhD, Chamber of Commerce and director, cardiac care. Cath Lab Metro Group of Hospitals. Dr. Sunila Garg, let me begin with you. Ma'am, there has been a lot of debate in recent days over whether it really makes sense to impose night curfews. Many doctors have also raised questions saying it's not as if coronavirus only travels at night. And then on the other hand, you have these big political rallies with thousands of people attending without masks taking place during the day. Is this really a sound decision, you believe, that will help us in containing the spread of COVID?
Neha, it's a very, very important question. I feel that any kind of super spreader events have got to be avoided, which we have been discussing time and again with you on your channel. And you have been showing, you know, the kind of, you know, the crowds, which are really mind-boggling. I feel despite, you know, we see the large number of cases, and, you know, it's the return of COVID in form of Omicron. But then another thing which is also very important is that the, you know, the there has been a guideline, you know, which has come out that if the number of cases are less than 0.5%, 0.5 to 1%, and then 5% and more than 5%. So, you know, we have to have some kind of, strategy where, you see, we need to open only the essential supplies. We can do away with the non-essential ones. If there are standalone shops that can be taken care of, educational institutions, whether they need to open or not. So we have got different categories of things under which we have categorized, you know. So we have to look at that whether these kind of things are being implemented or not, that is important. But, you know, the kind of scenarios which you are showing in terms of, you know, the markets and all that, it is very, very important role of administration to control the crowds in a staggered manner. And only, you know, the essential ones need to be opened and the rest can be opened in a staggered manner, like if we talk of odd even and all that. But implementation is a very major challenge. But at no cost, we should compromise with the COVID-appropriate behavior and two doses of vaccination. That is one thing which is very, very important. One should make sure that people who are doubly vaccinated should only be allowed to enter these, you know, places, whether we call it as marketplaces, public places and all that. Alone, night curfew is not going to serve the purpose. That is one of the most important things. And when you talked about the election rallies and all that, I feel that it is very important at this point of time. Election Commission has to take a serious review of the whole situation, whether, you know, they will be able to manage the crowds or whether the guidelines will be there. Because when once upon a time we talked about, you know, in terms of digital rallying and all that, which was not feasible. But then again, you know, I feel that we need to really look at that kind of a situation so that, you know, we can avoid this kind of a super spreader event. Thank you.
All right, ma'am, you've made yourself quite clear. Night curfews alone will not help. We certainly need to take better measures to control crowds at malls and markets. And what are we going to do about the political rallies? Because our netas don't seem to learn any lessons. Dr. Anusha Rohit, if I could come to you at this point. Again, what is your take on, you know, this debate that we have currently on whether night curfews are really effective in containing the spread of COVID-19. There are many experts who are questioning it and also saying that we've not really learnt our lessons from the second wave. What kind of measures do you really think we need to take at this moment as opposed to what we seem to be doing?
Thank you, Neha, for having me on the show. And what we need to go is to understand science at the base level. And what we understand by the Omicron or the Omicron variant is that the transmission is extremely high, whereas the admission to emergencies in comparison to Delta is dropped from 30 to 45% as per the new BMJ article that has just come out, or the admission to hospitals dropped down by 50 to 70%. Now, considering that we have all of these, if each of us take responsibility and like the previous speaker said, if we are going to have COVID appropriate behavior of wearing responsibly our masks, taking our vaccinations, it is so difficult to convince people to take two doses of their vaccination. People have taken one dose and then they feel, how can they get COVID? So these kind of things, I think now the government has opened up the third dose as well. I think what we need to do is to understand that masking is extremely important. If each of us behave responsibly, we do not need to worry about night curfews, which are of no use at all. We need to avoid super spreader events and avoid crowding and pay great attention to ventilation mm-hmm. in a closed space. So we need to understand that malls, etc., where there is a lot of closed spaces, are more likely to spread events, or say, for example, mm-hmm. functions or marriages or any of these where there's a closed community sitting together, that's more likely to spread an event than an open space rally. Now, the problem is that we don't understand how the spread happens, but we do, have a lot of number of positives coming up, and mm-hmm. that is something we need to work on. So if each of us behave responsibly, mask up, avoid unnecessary crowds, avoid, take our vaccinations on time, and, avoid being too close to people, mm-hmm. I think we would be able to get over this. Night curfews, lockdowns are not going to be of any use at this point of time.
Okay.
But if we are going to have no other way to control all of these things, then there's no other way to, imply or implicate people to understand.
All right.
Appropriate behavior needs to be done.
All right, no doubt we need to adhere to COVID appropriate behavior, but you're quite clear that you don't believe night curfews and lockdowns really work. Since you talked about vaccines, let's just bring our viewers up to speed on India's latest vaccination figures. Well, 62% of all adult Indians are now fully vaccinated, and the government is also now rolling out boosters from January. The first priority, we were told by the Health Ministry today, would be those healthcare workers and frontline workers who received their second jab 9 months ago. So we're certainly taking steps in the right direction. We've come a long way, but we still have a long way to go, because remember, as has just been pointed out, the rate of transmissibility of the Omicron variant is extremely high. And a lot of the people who've been infected with Omicron in recent days were in fact fully vaccinated. On that note, let me bring in Dr. Sameer Gupta into the discussion. Dr. Gupta, welcome to the show. Your take on this raging debate on whether night curfews really help. There's been a lot of mocking of this measure that's been taken by state government, with many experts also saying it's not as if coronavirus ventures out only at night and, takes a break during political rallies during the day.
I think it's a great point about the benefit of night curfew or not. The way I'm looking at it is a little bit different than what the other speaker said. The first and foremost thing is to try and tell the citizens of India that this is not something to be taken lightly. Now, how do you communicate that message? Putting in night curfew to a certain extent may tell the average person who's now become very lax. It was just 6 months ago when we were all raging in the second wave, and there was death and devastation everywhere. So, but people seem to be back to the normal lives, and you've seen that everywhere. So, putting a night curfew, putting some sort of measure out there may perhaps tell the citizens, tell the people, this is there. It's something serious. We need to try and not have big weddings, for that matter. Or maybe we should not go out and party on New Year's Eve, which is possibly the case. So this is kind of, I'm looking at it from that standpoint. Yes, the hospitalizations are possible. The incidence of hospitalization is lower, and possibly the severity is a little bit lower. But you have to look at it in a different perspective also. So supposing there are 100 people, who get infected with the Delta variant. And for the sake of argument, 10% of those people require hospitalization. So that means you require 20 hospital beds. Sorry, 10 hospital beds if with a 10% hospitalization rate. And this is just semantic, just numbers I'm just throwing out there. They may not be the actual statistic. Now, we know the Omicron is exponentially more infective. So instead of 100 patients, you will probably have 1,000 people being infected. And with a 1% hospitalization rate, you still need 10 beds. So the challenge is not of the severity. It is overwhelming the healthcare system, something that we are seeing across the world. We're seeing that in America. We're seeing that in England. We're seeing that in parts of Europe. So that is what we also have to remember. Yes, it is less infectious, but because more number of people will get infected, that we may once again reach a state where the healthcare system is getting overwhelmed. We do need to have COVID-appropriate behavior at all times. People are getting lax. I've been talking to multiple people over the last few weeks, and people are like, oh, you know what? The COVID is here. We can't stop our lives. The same thing that we heard exactly a year ago, but the story is far from over.
The story is far from over. There is no doubt that cases are on the rise because the transmissibility of this variant is extremely high. And when you have such overwhelming numbers, the healthcare system can get overwhelmed, as is happening in many parts of the US, UK and other parts of Europe. Before I go back to Dr. Garg, Dr. Gupta, your thoughts on whether you believe, this question is for Dr. Sameer Gupta. Do you believe, you know, we could actually have another lockdown coming? Though a lot of experts don't seem to think lockdowns and night curfews help. But given the way things are going, do you really believe we have another lockdown coming?
You know, the Delhi government is already planning, you know, the schools are closed, colleges are closed. There is this entire thing which came out of the paper today, that, you know, international events are closed, cinema halls are going to be closed, spas and wellness clinics and yoga institutes are going to be closed. So we may be heading to, I don't think that there's going to be a partial, there's going to be a complete lockdown in the near future. We may have, something of, you know, the markets going on odd even or something of that sort, if the numbers go really high and people don't pay heed to it. But I don't think, I'm not sure if the entire lockdown is going to help. Lockdown is going to
because it clearly did not help, during the first and the second waves. Dr. Garg, let me come to you at this point. The question that we really need to focus on right now, even as we talk about our vaccination drive and COVID-appropriate behavior, is how prepared is India's healthcare infrastructure? Can we really hope that this time it will not be overwhelmed the way it was during the second wave? Most doctors like you and others have said that night curfews and lockdowns don't really help. But going by the way things are panning out, like we saw those scary visuals that emerged from some Delhi malls or the Sarojini Nagar market here in the national capital, jam-packed with shoppers, most of them not wearing masks. If that sort of continues, do you actually see that there could be another lockdown? And do you believe it'll really help?
Neha, first of all, I'll say that, whatever we have seen from 24th November onwards with regard to Omicron cases, right from Africa to UK to United States to Germany, France, Italy and all that, most of the cases are mild, which is lucky for us. And if this virus is going to replace the Delta variant, which is a very, very severe kind of, which caused very severe infection, so it is important to understand that this virus in many ways is very mild virus, but we are watching the situation. That doesn't mean that we become lax and, there's no time for complacency. But as far as, the second wave was concerned, it taught us, about the preparedness of our systems, about preparedness of our ICUs, oxygen beds, and also, we have also prepared with regard to children also. Over a period of time, this period has not gone in waste, but the system has been preparing itself gradually because we are all very sure that, virus has not gone out of our lives, and that's how, from the Indian perspective, the vaccination drive is also going on slowly and steadily also. I'll not say slowly now. It's going quite fast. We have done 141 crore vaccination also. And we hope to touch 150 crore before we start from 10th of January for the other set of, when we call it as precautionary dose. So it is important to look from that perspective. So I hope so. that we don't require so much of hospitalization. And from, you know, 2 days back onwards, we have started focusing on home isolation. And earlier also, I myself was involved in preparation of home isolation guidelines with preparation with along with USAID, JAPIGO and NISTA.
Okay.
And that has been already submitted to Government of India. So we need to empower our communities. We need to, you know, rely on our telemedicine systems. We need to empower, again, our healthcare providers, how to monitor people at home
okay.
and also sensitize family members as well.
Okay, okay. Dr. Anusha Rohit, even though many are saying that, you know, Omicron only causes mild illness, most haven't had serious symptoms so far, yet we have seen hospitalizations going up in the UK and in South Africa. Now, maybe those are people who are not vaccinated. However, given the size of our population and given how huge, you know, the segments that have comorbidities really are, there is a likelihood that the healthcare system could in fact get overwhelmed if Omicron continues to spread like wildfire. Is that a concern that you have?
Absolutely. I think the healthcare system has to be prepared for any eventuality in the pandemic. It's always better to be overprepared than underprepared. And as far as the Omicron is concerned, I would agree that yes, we can get overwhelmed with it. And the problem is also that we don't test early enough. We are not having that many testing kits which have the S gene escape, mechanism, the S gene detection system, which helps us detect what that this is an Omicron. We need to have people testing more frequently. We need to have them also, isolating and keeping themselves away so that they are not infecting more people. And I think yes, it can overwhelm the healthcare system. That's always a concern, especially for a populous country like India, and we need to be always on our guard.
Mm-hmm.
I will not discredit the fact that we have to be having COVID appropriate behavior at all times, more so than what you would see in the US or the UK,
mm-hmm.
which has better coverage of vaccines. Nonetheless, I think we still we have a good coverage. Nonetheless, we have a long way to go. We have still a sizable population that is susceptible. And therefore, we would need to keep all of these in mind.
Absolutely. And you make an interesting point there. And I want to put that question to Dr. Sameer Gupta as we wrap up this discussion. Dr. Gupta, do you see a dichotomy there that on the one hand, countries like the US and UK have had, much better vaccine coverage than the rest of the world. And yet you see the healthcare systems now being overwhelmed, huge number of Omicron cases, many hospitalizations taking place. Now, one can't be sure if all of these people who've been hospitalized in these countries were in fact unvaccinated. But it is very clear that this variant, the Omicron variant, does have not just high transmissibility, but an immune escape, because a lot of reinfections and breakthrough infections have been reported. Keeping that in mind, keeping the experience of the West in mind, how concerned do you think we need to be?
Well, talking to my colleagues across the world in the US, majority of them are saying that the majority of the patients who are currently in their ICUs are unvaccinated people. So there's a big anti-vax lobby, as they call it, in the US and in the Western world. In India, we've got 61% of the people who are completely vaccinated. Now, that being said, there is an immune escape mechanism. There are cases coming up of reinfection. However, majority of those reinfections are that we are getting reports are of mild and don't require and have not tipped those patients out to the ICU. So hopefully all will be well, and we will gather this, and we'll all use COVID appropriate behavior. The fact that we are all vaccinated, the fact that the boosters are coming in very soon. Now the one thing which is coming in is also that a lot of people who are being admitted, especially in New York, are children, people yes, less than 5 years of age, less than 10 years of age, who've not been vaccinated. So that is definitely a concern. You may not be infected yourself. You may just think it's mild, but you get it home and your children.
Dr. Gupta, one last question, and I request you to give us a quick answer. There is no doubt that we have to focus on vaccines, but can we really bet on Omicron causing mild illness, as many seem to believe at the moment?
you know, majority of these cases are coming out to be mild. There are some reports from the US. So you know, it's also relative, right? And yes, it may be milder to Delta, but Delta was higher than the original Wuhan strain.
Yes.
So where does it fit in? You know, we will wait for that data to come out.
Absolutely. At least according to the WHO, the jury on that is still out. And therefore, there is absolutely no room for complacency. Something that all of us can agree on is that we need to be very careful, keep our guard up, adhere to COVID appropriate behavior. Get vaccinated if you haven't already. If you fall into the eligible category, please go get those boosters when they're rolled out in the month of January. And doctors also seem to believe that night curfews do not work, lockdowns do not work. We need better measures in place, and we certainly need our healthcare system to be geared up for the imminent third wave. On that note, I'd like to thank all my panelists for joining me on the show, and thanks to the viewers for watching.